game on the menu tonight, folks, between the Kentucky Wildcats and the Kansas Jayhawks. And here's a look at our Star Watch comparison. And there are the starting lineups for each team.
Well, basketball fans, we have a great matchup for you to keep your eyes on at the small forward position.
Well, Duck, we've got two top-ranked teams going head-to-head. This should be a great game.
Well, the interesting thing about these teams is that everybody on the roster is pretty good. Both teams are getting national attention. Win or lose, this is a great test for these teams to learn and develop.
The Wildcats are number 7 in the polls right now, Dick.
I'll tell you one thing. To be in the top 25, you better be able to focus and to really respond to the challenges that you face.
And they go into their motion offense, working with 4 around 1 here.
I'll tell you, the 4 around 1 makes it tough to defend the big guy on the interior with one guy. It really does. You got to get help on him, and if you don't get help, he's going to have a field day on the interior.
Controlling the ball. The shooting guard takes the pass in the paint. That's a momentum buster.
He's here to fight, baby.
On the outside. Let's watch the move as he works his man and out a fadeaway jumper. Sinks the shot. Side. They're working around the perimeter. He looks for 3. Missed the jumper.
Nice step in it, man. Take a look right here. Little Barista glove in shorts. Little ballerina hanging in the air.
He's a jack of all trades. Nice to have you along with us tonight. Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews alongside. I'm Brad Nessler. We got a good one going. I don't know if there's such a thing as a good foul, but that might have been one right there, Dick.
Hey, Mr. Nessler, I like that type of play. He's saying to the defense, no easy baskets for you. We're going to force you to make shots.
Here's another solid junior, Dick.
He's been around for a couple of years now. He knows what he's capable of bringing to the team. This is the year when players start to transition into more of a leadership role and help get the most out of younger guys on the team.
Definitely doing their thing. Listen to the chant.
Who says there's no such thing as a home court advantage?
Gave it up. In the lane. I wonder if he's ever going to get any help from his teammates, Dick. He's doing it all and then some.
I'm sorry, Brad, but this young fellow seems to be their only hope at the moment.
They're working around the perimeter. From the corner, bust the jumper. Newman receives the pass. He puts up the J. Nope. He takes the rebound. Tries one from three-point land. Nails a sweet jumper.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. Puts it on the floor. It's around a fadeaway. He hammers it home.
You can almost see that coming. They were a little bit lazy on a defensive end. Mr. Excitement with that jam.
On the dribble, gives it up.
It looks as though they have a shooter spotting up.
The point guard takes the pass. He misses the jumper.
And the fans love it, man. They love it. Our house, baby, our house.
On the outside. And now the fadeaway jumper.
Jumper didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly.
Gave it up. Puts up the jumper. Off the mark. On the left side. He goes up with it. Nails the J. Newman receives the ball. Jumper. Bust the J. This is the type of guy that can throw the whole kitchen sink at you if you're not careful.
He's got size plus everything else. It's going to be fun to watch in different ways he gets involved in this game.
Preston receives the ball. They got it. Washington receives the ball. They'll work it around the arc. Richards, his mediocre play has really gotten to him.
Brad, he's in what many people call a funk. Emotionally, he's got to turn things around.
Good job defensively. They just won't get many openings.
Pressure in the basketball.
Great block shot. On the wing. There's the rejection. Green manages to keep it in. Pushes it up. Buries it home. That was a great delivery on the back cut.
That's a bang bang play, Brad. That's a great cut and an even better pass.
Trying to pack it inside. He fires away. Perfectly executed. Washington handles the feed. Trying to feed the low block. With the fadeaway. Gets the fade to fall. All right, let's check in third member of our team again. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Coach has been quite animated over here on the sidelines. It's all positive, though. He's pleased with the manner in which they're playing their up-tempo style. I overheard him saying that if this continues, he likes his team's chances. Guys?
EA, of course, our third member, getting that additional insight and dealings from the sideline. He unloads a three. Gets the J to fall. Now they work it around the perimeter. And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with the blocked shot.
Isolated on the outside. They work it around the arc looking for the open jumper. That's definitely not the shot they were looking for, Dick.
That shot was definitely ill-advised.
On the left side. With the J. Missed it. With a bucket. Sinks it. Looking for a good shot. Unloads. Can't connect. The Jayhawks have a basketball program that has a lot of history.
Hey, success has been key in building this tradition.
Talk about being a tough place to play. Check out this arena.
Hey, this is what you call a hostile environment, Mr. Nestler. Not only is this crowd loud, but they give their team that next level of energy that lasts all game long.
Moving it around the perimeter.
I tell you, they all want to take it to the rack. High wire rack, baby. Little tipsy dude, Dunkaroo.
Takes the jumper. Nails a sweet jumper. Had a momentary look from three-point land.
Run him right into the screen again. What did I say?
Takes the pass in the paint. Richard picks up the foul. Second team foul. Well, it commits an intentional foul there to prevent the easy basket.
Well, it's a smart play, Brad, especially if you can afford to use a personal foul. I like his mentality. No easy basket.
Well, Dick, here's a player in just his freshman year.
I tell you, what an exciting time in a young man's life. It's that student-athlete experience really preparing him for the rest of his life. He drained it. Got him a nylon, NBN.
Up and inside.
He launches a three. Scores it. They work the perimeter. Little two-man action. About 7 minutes remaining. For two, off the glass and no good. Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
He attempts a jump shot. Nope.
Check that basketball with that good defensive rebound.
They need to get out and run their lanes now.
Gotta take some pride on the defensive end.
The Jayhawks can't afford to have him pick up too many more fouls. Let's take a look at this young guy's great performance tonight, Vic.
I tell you, as a coach, Brad, it's always nice to have a player surprisingly step up and perform better than expected. We'll have to keep a close eye on him moving forward.
Downtown, knocks it down. Both teams are looking to get something going here. They look to get it to the inside. He makes a nice shot fake. He tries the jumper. Off the mark. On the dribble, gives it up. They've got a three-point shooter spotting up. Looking for a good shot. He shoots from the deep corner. Bust the J. Goes up for two. Off the glass and no good. Pushes it up. Goes up with a shot. Busts the jumper. On the left side. We're going to move it around the perimeter. From the corner. Jumper won't go. On the right side. Tries for two. Off the mark with that shot. Drains it. Working it around the perimeter. He wants a three. He has taken his team completely out of this game.
These young guys have to remember to let the game come to you. Don't force the action.
Out on the right wing. Here comes the ball screen. He shoots from the top of the key. They get it to go. About 4 minutes remaining on the game clock. Gave it up. And the slam.
Look at that spacing.
He shoots the jumper. Missed the jumper. On the dribble, gives it up.
He's got hops like you, man. He got hops like you.
It is pretty similar.
Wow. I didn't realize my partner was a high riser. Try to go inside.
And they do. They got it on the low block. We're at the 3 minute mark with a deep shot from outside. Off the glass and no good. He pulls up with a jumper. Gets the J to fall. Newman handles the feed. He attempts the three. In and out. They wanted an offensive interference call and don't get it.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
He puts up the J. He seems determined to take the tough shot.
Well, they're not falling, and the offense is being totally taken out of sync.
With the jumper off the mark. They got the offensive rebound and the stick back. On the outside. For the bucket. He gets the bucket to fall. Goes up. Missed it. One minute left on the game clock.
Unusual mistake there by the senior.
They work it around the perimeter. It's not smart to just throw it out of bounds. It's a team effort across the board so far today, Dick.
I tell you, if you're on the floor, that means your coach trusts you and believes you can play a role out there. Hey, we've seen some great plays from a number of different players so far, and that always makes things difficult for an opponent.
Let's go courtside. What do you got for us, Aaron?
The sideline has been trying to get the team to play more up-tempo. The coaches feel that this is the style that they need to play and will work for them. Definitely something for us to track moving forward, Brad.
Thanks, EA. Aaron Andrews providing that extra bit of insight for us. Terrible execution on offense. Trying to feed inside. He goes up with it. The missed shot. Baker handles the feed. Here's a double team with a big shot. Doesn't go. At the end of the first half, the Jayhawks are up by four. Kansas did a fabulous job of controlling the backboard in the first half, Dick.
Hey, controlling is right, partner. They know if they dominate on the boards, the chance of pulling this one out is significantly higher.
Number 54 is put back in the game.
Hey, this team easily comes apart without him out there, Brad. Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps.
Look at that. That's unbelievable, baby.
On the outside from three-point range.
Jumper didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly.
They'll work it around the arc. He attempts the jump shot. Jumper won't go. Let's check in with Erin Andrews and what she's got in store for us, Erin.
Well, one of Dick's points of emphasis was forcing turnovers. I think we'd all agree that they've done a pretty good job of this. At halftime, the coaching staff really stressed that they must continue to do the things they did well in the first half. Forcing turnovers was obviously one of them.
Thanks, Erin. Well, if there is such a thing as a good foul, that was probably it.
Sure was, Brad. He fouled to prevent the easy basket.
Well, Dick, this young man's now in his second year.
Brad, he's got that first year of experience under his belt. So this season, his team is going to be looking for him a lot more.
The rebound. They've got a player spotting up on the three. Now they work it around the perimeter. He shoots from the corner. Nails the jumper. Washington handles the pass. Nails the J. The pick. There's the roll. On the left side. Gave it up. He tries the jumper. They get it to go.
He wants it.
He's asking for it on the low block, and they don't get it to him. Knocks it down. On the left side. Isolated on the outside. They're working around the arc, looking for the open jumper. Can't connect. Get a change of possession. Let's take another look at this deep three. They'll give him that pass all night long. So now let's see what they do with the inbounds play on the baseline. He shoots from the deep corner, gets the J to fall. Handles the pass. There was no doubt about that one. Need the low post for two. Gets it to go. Preston receives the ball. He shoots the jumper. Knocked it down. It. Change of possession. The Jayhawks are moving the ball well. They're getting contributions from a number of players on both ends of the court.
You know, everyone's been getting involved. Passing, rebounding, taking the ball through the hoop. A great team effort will always keep a team in.
Backcourt violation.
Carelessness with the ball is never a good thing.
Boy, assist to turnover ratios are big, and that's a big turnover.
I'll tell you, you're turning the ball over too often. You can't win when you do that.
He's taking too many unnecessary shots, Dick.
And he's costing his team their rhythm.
He puts up the three ball. He misses the J. There's a slam.
Great execution. That's offensive efficiency at its best.
Now, getting set up here in a four-round one.
I love the four-round one, especially when you got a big guy who can pass the ball exceptionally well as score. Now you got to give help on him, and it leaves people open on the perimeter, and they better be able to make that open jump shot. Trying to come up with a defensive stop. There's that high screen.
Nice flash out defensively. Receives the pass. On the dribble, gives it up. He bombs from outside. Missed the jumper. Gave it up for three. Off the mark. The elbow, they feed down to the low block. Takes his jumper off the mark. Green handles the pass. Launches the three. It'd be nice if he could get some assistance out there. That young man is doing it all for his team right now.
Call this a one-man show, Brad. I don't know if it's a good thing or a bad thing.
Dumps it in. Loose ball, great play. And we'll get a change of possession. Let's check out this jumper one more time. The Jayhawks go into their zone motion now. Down inside. Too physical. Oh, it looked like he had an easy basket coming up, but the defense commits a foul instead.
Great play there, Brad. He was able to foul him in order to prevent the easy basket.
A couple of free ones. Gets the first shot. They're seeing them all fall from the line tonight.
That's a crucial plus down the stretch, Brad.
They're making good use of their free throw opportunities tonight.
Good free throw shooting teams seem to always give themselves a chance to win.
Count that as a personal foul. Well, I don't know if there's such a thing as a good foul, but that might have been one right there, Dick.
Hey, Mr. Nessler, I like that type of play. He's saying to the defense, no easy baskets for you. We're going to force you to make shots.
He'll visit the charity stripe. Sinks it. That line is really being good to him tonight, Dick.
That line's always good, Brad. These guys just have to make good use of it.
Two at the charity strike. That trap could spell some trouble. He can't get around the trap.
The man can't get past it, Brad.
So Dick's so important now at the point. The point guard will set things up and the other four will go to work.
Well, you know what they're doing is a four around with a post guy on the interior. And they're trying to get that ball to the inside, but they're playing with four people on the exterior.
He takes a three. Missed it. There's sort of a snapshot of our game tempo.
We've seen a combination of both short and long possessions here, Brad. Nothing wrong with that if that's your team's ideal style of play.
Off the glass and no good. Looking for a good shot. From the corner, bust the jumper. Turnaround jumper and come up short. The Wildcats running their zone offense here, Dick.
Hey, one thing that works well against zones is overloading the side. Overload a side and force the defense to shift out of their desired position.
Well, it commits an intentional foul there to prevent the easy basket.
Well, it's a smart play, Brad, especially if you can afford to use a personal foul. I like his mentality. No easy basket.
He goes to the line for the first time. He misses his first shot. He hits the second. So Dick's so important now at the point. The point guard will set things up and the other four will go to work.
Well, you know what they're doing is a four around with a post guy on the interior, and they're trying to get that ball to the inside, but they're playing with four people on the exterior.
Moving it around the perimeter. From the corner, jumper won't go. Goes up for two. The missed shot. Get it earlier than that. Tie game. On the left side. Number 15 is charged with the foul. Fourth team foul. Well, if there is such a thing as a good foul, that was probably it.
Sure was, Brad. He fouled to prevent the easy basket.
He is going to the line. Gets his first.
those free throws can. Let's go back on that campus. It's BMOC. Big man on campus, baby.
Tries for two. Can't get it to go. And once again, our two featured players here in tonight's Star Watch. The baseline inbounds. Zone motion now for the bucket. You betcha. For two. Got it. So, Dick, so important now at the point. The point guard will set things up, and the other four will go to work.
Well, you know what they're doing is a four around with a post guy on the interior, and they're trying to get that ball to the inside, but they're playing with four people on the exterior.
And a momentary look from three-point land, and score it. Gives it up, goes up for two, nails the jumper. Tries for two, makes the shot.
There's the trap.
The circle, they work it around the perimeter. He tries the three ball, nails a sweet jumper. The Wildcats are all about running and pushing the tempo, aren't they, Dick?
Hey, that's definitely their thing, Brad. They love to get players who look to attack offensively. Guys who...
With the block. Loose ball save. There's a high percentage shot.
Wow, what hops, baby, what hops.
Feed the low post for the bucket. Great shot.
Up and inside.
Gets the feed down low. Now the turnaround jumper. Missed the jumper. Washington receives the ball. About 6 minutes remaining in the game clock. They work the perimeter from three-point territory. He misses the jumper. Pushes it up. Richards keeps it in. Ball's going to stay down here. The Jayhawks move into their zone motion offense.
Boy, I'll tell you what, Matt. The zone motion offense creates a lot of opportunities if you get ball movement and player movement. If you get people to step into the gaps in the zone and reverse the ball, you'll get good shots.
Work the perimeter.
Spacing's so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
Can't connect. Garrett receives the ball. And they go into their motion offense, working with four around one here.
Well, the four around one motion offense is a good offense when a team has a big guy who can play with his back toward the back.
Rejected.
Hey, we've seen some great block shots. Teammates love it. They applaud.
About 5 minutes remaining. Throws it up. For the bucket. He nails the shot. This one might go down to the final buzzer.
In close games like this, Brad, offensive and defensive execution is very important.
Dumps it in. Now in transition. For the deuce. Rims out. Gave it up. For two. Off the glass. He grabs the rebound. Goes up for two. Off the backboard. About 4 minutes remaining on the game clock. The student body appears to be pumped up, and they are ready to explode.
They're rocking right now. My goodness.
Oh, it looked like he had an easy basket coming up, but the defense commits a foul instead.
Great play there, Brad. He was able to foul him in order to prevent the easy basket. I like it when a team gets to the free throw line. It shows that they're being aggressive. The key is to get to the line early in the game and often.
Everything looked good but the result. Looking for a good shot. He shoots. Gets the J to fall. Tries for two. Off the glass and no good. The Wildcats are all about up-tempo style, aren't they, Dick?
Well, you need to have some great athletes, Brad. Guys who can get up and down the court and make plays going at incredible speeds.
Fed the low block. For the bucket. With the layup. We're at the 3 minute mark. He takes the shot from the baseline. He shoots from the top of the circle, scores it. On the dribble, gives it up. And up and under.
That's a good post play because the footwork was excellent. So many guys walk with their pivot foot. He does a great job showing ball fake, and good footwork keeping his pivot foot down.
Looking to move it around the perimeter. He looks for three. Bust the J. Gave it up. We're at the 2 minute mark. They go with the entry pass, on the post, turnaround jumper. On the left side. Working it around the perimeter. He puts up the tray. Comes up empty. Dumps it in. For the deuce. Was that beautiful or what? He shoots from downtown. Bust the J. 3 points is the difference.
That's right, so somebody better guard the York.
Newman handles the pass. For two. The layup is good. Good find on that back cut, Mr. Vitale.
Brad, those are the type of reads you look for in practice.
Trying to come up with a steal, and they do. Here they come now on a turnover. Well, they're going to have to find him a sub, Dick. That's his fourth foul.
Yeah, they're going to have to decide what to do with him. The fouls are mounted, and they can't afford for him to be on the bench.
Tough team to foul because they shoot such a good percentage from the line.
You love to see a team take pride in shooting a high percentage from the line.
can't get one to fall. On the right side.
Right there, they missed him inside. You gotta get the ball when a guy is open. That's a special art, feeding the post.
The students are all fired up and ready to do whatever's necessary to help their team win.
You can't forget about them. The winning humor and dedication to their teams. You can't find this in any other team sport.
The Jayhawks call a timeout. Let's go courtside to Aaron Andrews.
Based on the score and the time remaining, the coaches will be looking to calm their players down. Adrenaline levels may have shot up over the last few possession guys, so the coach will be looking to reduce any anxiety. It should make for an interesting finish. Back up to you.
Well, Dick, it's always important to come out of a timeout with a game plan, I think.
You know, very important. It's a chance to get your team on the same page, talk about what's happened previously and what's about to happen in the future. I hate it when teams come out of a timeout unorganized and without a plan.
Just about ready for play to resume. Pushes it up. Looks like they're setting up into their zone motion. Nails the sweet jumper. He up fakes. He takes the three. He buries the jumper. We're back. Dick Vitale and Brad Nessler with you here, ready for the inbound after that timeout. Pushes it. Zone offense now. He goes for three. No. Well, it's time to start fouling. They got to stop the clock, didn't they? And they continue to foul to stop the clock. Kansas couldn't seem to get over the hump in this losing battle tonight.
They had a chance to win this one against a comparable team, but they ended up defeating themselves.
So for Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews, I'm Brad Nessler saying so long.